Friends, in the previous two videos we have discussed about synthesis of heme, right? Now today we will move to regulation of heme synthesis. Heme synthesis, how heme is synthesized? Heme is nothing but ferrous ion incorporated into protoporphyrin 9. Okay, this protoporphyrin 9 is also known as protoporphyrin 3. So protoporphyrin 3 and protoporphyrin 9 are equal. Different scientists named it differently. Okay, so if you see protoporphyrin 9 as protoporphyrin 3 in some textbooks, it is also true. Okay, so succinyl coenzyme A react with the glycine in the presence of ALA synthase to form ALA, right? This two aminolevulinic acid molecules react to form porphobilinogen. Okay, four porphobilinogen molecule react to form HMB. This porphobilinogen is a monopyrrole ring, and this HMB means hydroxymethylbilin, right? Hydroxymethylbilin is a tetrapyrrole linear molecule, right? Then this linear molecule cyclizes to form UPG3. Okay, it's a tetrapyrrole cyclized form, right? This UPG3 in the presence of UPG decarboxylase forms coproporphyrinogen 3, right? CPG3. This CPG3 in the presence of CPG oxidase forms protoporphyrinogen, and protoporphyrinogen oxidase convert this protoporphyrinogen 3 into protoporphyrin 3. This protoporphyrin 3 or protoporphyrin 9 react with the ferrous ion to form heme. This is the whole pathway of heme synthesis, right? So the enzyme, there are 8 enzymes: ALA synthase, ALA dehydratase, HMB synthase, UPG3 cos synthase, UPG decarboxylase, CPG oxidase, protoporphyrinogen oxidase and ferrochelatase, right? Two ALA molecules react to form PBG in the presence of ALA dehydratase, right? Then protoporphyrin 3 and protoporphyrin 9 are same, and there are 8 steps in heme synthesis. So there are 8 enzymes but 9 genes. These 8 enzymes are coded by 9 genes. Why? Because ALAS has 2 genes, ALAS 1 and ALAS 2. ALAS 1 gene is present everywhere. Okay, everywhere in our body ALAS 1 is present, but ALAS 2 is present only on X chromosome, and it is erythroid specific. ALAS 2 is erythroid specific. Okay, so 8 steps, 8 enzymes, 9 genes, 9 genes, ALAS has 2 genes. Okay, now we will move to regulation of heme synthesis. Okay, regulation of heme synthesis. Erythroid cells synthesize 85% of heme. Okay, erythroid cells synthesize 85% of heme. Hepatic cells synthesize remaining 15% of heme. Okay, so regulation mainly occur in hepatic cells where heme is synthesized based on metabolic needs. Okay, main regulation of heme synthesis occurs in hepatic cell where 15% of heme is synthesized. There are 3 levels of regulation of heme synthesis. One is repression mechanism, second is compartmentalization, and third is allosteric regulation. What is repression mechanism? At gene level, hepatic ALA synthesis is regulated by repression mechanism. Heme inhibits the synthesis of ALA synthase by acting as a corepressor. If plenty of heme is there, it acts as a corepressor to prevent ALA synthesis. Okay, synthesis of ALA synthase. Then second regulation occurs as compartmentalization. You know, heme synthesis occurs in two organelles. One is mitochondria, another is cytosol. So different compartment, synthesis of heme in different compartment regulate the heme synthesis. First, 6th, 7th and 8th steps are occur in mitochondria. why this compartmentalization, how this compartmentalization regulates heme synthesis? Because the this organelle concentrate the materials to synthesize heme. Okay, specific organelle concentrate in specific areas the synthetic materials. Okay, synthetic materials of heme is concentrated in specific organelle so that it is easy, and the reactants, that is the products, are transported to different organelle. Thus this compartmentalization help in regulation of heme synthesis. Okay, another level of regulation is allostric regulation. Heme is a negative allostric effector of allosynthase 1. Okay, heme act as a negative allosteric effector of allosynthase 1. So those three levels of regulation you have to know. Now we will move to porphyrias. Okay, what is this porphyrias? Porphyrias are disorders of heme synthesis. If there is a problems in heme synthesis steps, porphyrias will result. They are disorders of heme synthesis, and increased production and excretion of porphyrins and their precursors results in porphyrias. Okay, there are 8 enzymes in the heme synthesis, so there will be 8 porphyrias. 8 enzymes result in 8 porphyrias. Defect in 8 enzymes result in 8 porphyrias. There are 2 types. These 8 porphyrias are divided into 2 types, erythroid type and hepatic type. Usually, not exclusively, usually this erythroid type of porphyrias are autosomal recessive inheritance, and hepatic type of porphyrias are autosomal dominant inheritance. Okay. Erythroid type of porphyrias are autosomal recessive and it will be chronic, right? It will be chronic. But hepatic type is autosomal dominant and it shows acute manifestation. Why this erythroid type is chronic? Porphyrin arises in bone marrow, which reaches capillaries and shows cutaneous manifestation. Okay, this cutaneous manifestations are chronic. Why this erythroid type shows a cutaneous manifestation? Porphyrin arises in bone marrow, reaches capillaries and shows a cutaneous manifestation. Hepatic types show acute manifestation like acute abdominal pain, etc. So usually this erythroid type are autosomal recessive and shows cutaneous manifestation, and hepatic types are autosomal dominant and shows acute manifestations. So we will deal with the 8 porphyrias. 8 enzymes defect shows 8 porphyrias, so deal with each and every one. First enzyme for heme synthesis is allosynthase, right? Allosynthesis is the first enzyme. The first step occurs in mitochondria. Succinyl coenzyme A and glycine react to form ALA. Okay, in the presence of ALAs. This allosynthase has 2 genes, as you already learned. We will deal with ALAs 2 gene now. ALAs 2 gene have 2 defects. One is gain of function mutation and other is loss of function mutation. If there is gain of function mutation of ALAs 2 gene, it will result in X-linked protoporphyria. So, if gain of function mutation of ALAs 2 gene is there, increased synthesis of ALAs 2 occur, which result in X-linked protoporphyria. If ALAs 2 gene has loss of function mutation, it will result in anemia, not porphyria. It is not porphyria, but it is X-linked sideroblastic anemia. Because heme is not formed, so it will result in X-linked sideroblastic anemia. So only this enzyme shows this gain of function mutation. All other 7 enzymes show loss of function mutation in our body. The only ALA2 genus gain of function mutation, which result in X-linked protoporphyria. Sideroblastic anemia result in ALAS2 gene loss of function mutation. Then second enzyme is ALA dehydratase, right? 2 ALA molecules in the presence of ALA dehydratase form porphobilinogen in the second step. This is autosomal dominant porphyria. This results in autosomal dominant porphyria, but this name is a misnomer, right? Autosomal dominant porphyria shows autosomal recessive inheritance. Autosomal dominant porphyria shows autosomal recessive inheritance, thus it is a misnomer. This is also known as plumber porphyria. Why? This alardehydratase is inhibited by lead. We have learned that alardehydratase is a zinc containing enzyme which is inhibited by lead. So the porphyria result by alardehydratase is also known as plumber porphyria. This autosomal recessive inheritance and the symptoms are due to increase in ALA. Okay, ALA dehydrate is deficient, so the product ALA will increase in the body. Now, third enzyme. What is the third enzyme? This is HMB synthase, right? HMB synthase is also known as UPG1 synthase. How to remember HMB synthase is also known as UPG1 synthase because this HMB synthase enzyme give rise to product UPG1, this is a, or HMB, which is a linear tetrapyrrole, right? This HMB synthase deficiency will result in acute intermittent porphyrin. How we will remember it? This AIP, you can see this red line, right? This red line, red I, UPG1, there is also red. This AIP, UPG1, you can see similar. So we can remember HMB synthase or UPG1 synthase deficiency result in acute intermittent porphyria. And this is autosomal dominant. And this is hepatitype. This HMB synthase deficiency resulting acute intermittent porphyria is hepatitype. Acute abdominal pain and neurological manifestation as symptoms. There is no photosensitivity. There is no photosensitivity because porphyrins are not formed. Increased ALA and PBG. This HMB synthase deficiency, the result in increased ALA and PBG since end product inhibition is not effective. You know, ALA and PBG is increased in our body. So, barbiturates, which are ALA synthase inducer, precipitate the symptoms because more ALA are formed due to induction of ALA by barbiturates. Okay. Already symptoms are due to increased ALA and PBG. So AIP, acute intermittent porphyria, which is the acute abdomen, shows acute abdominal pain and the neurological manifestation result from HMB synthase deficiency or UPG1 synthase deficiency. Now the fourth step. What is the fourth step? This UPG1 or HMB, which is a linear tetrapyrrole molecule, cyclized to form UPG3. In the presence of UPG co-synthase. So, UPG co-synthase deficiency result in congenital erythropoietic porphyria. Congenital erythropoietic porphyria, which is a autosomal recessive inheritance. Since it is erythropoietic porphyria, it results from shows autosomal recessive inheritance. This UPG co-synthase deficiency or congenital erythropoietic porphyria is also known as Gutter's disease. The important point to remember is this Gutter's disease or congenital erythropoietic porphyria shows erythrodontia as symptom, as sign. Okay, what is this erythrodontia? When a UV light is reflected on teeth of this patient, a red fluorescence is seen. This is known as erythrodontia. Photosensitivity and repeated attack of dermatitis are the symptoms. Okay, erythrodontia is a sign and photosensitivity and repeat attack of dermatitis are the symptoms. Now, for porphyrias are over. Now, the next step is UPG3 by UPG decarboxylase enzyme. What will form? CPG3, right? So, UPG decarboxylase deficiency will lead to porphyria cutanea tata. I will remember this as there is a C here and there is a C here. So, UPG decarboxylase deficiency will result in porphyria cutanea tata. The main sign of this porphyria cutanea tata is blisters in the dorsum of hand. Blisters in the dorsum of hand. This shows autosomal dominant inheritance. There is neurovisceral manifestation and associated liver disease also seen. So does porphyria cutanea tata. Okay. Now the CPG3 by CPG oxidase will form protoporphyrinogen 3, right? So, CPG oxidase deficiency will lead to hereditary coproporphyria and it shows autosomal dominant inheritance and neurovisceral manifestations are there. The next step, PPG oxidized will convert this PPG into protoporphyrin, right? So PPG oxidized deficiency will lead to porphyria variegata. This is hepatic type and autosomal dominant inheritance, and it shows cutaneous manifestations. Then last enzyme, this is ferrochelatase, right? Incorporation of ferrous ion into protoporphyrin 3 or protoporphyrin 9 was done by ferrochelatase enzyme. This ferrochelatase deficiency will lead to erythropoietic protoporphyria, which shows autosomal recessive inheritance, right? Since it's erythropoietic protoporphyria, it shows autosomal recessive inheritance. So eight types of porphyrias are over, except 1, 2, 4, 8, all are autosomal dominant, right? In the first step, first porphyria, which was this X-linked porphyrias, right? X-linked porphyrias are autosomal recessive. And the second, do you remember? Okay, second also shows autosomal recessive. Then fourth and eighth also shows autosomal recessive. All other. That's remaining four shows autosomal dominant inheritance. Okay, most common porphyria is PCT or porphyria cutanea tarda. Then you heard of Soret band? There is a Soret band. What is this Soret band? At junction of UV light and visible light, there is an area at 400 nanometer. The porphyria absorb light in this region. This is known as Soret band. So in effect, porphyria absorb light in the Soret band region, right? This is all about porphyria. First go through these slides and my notes. After that you read textbook, so that will be clear. Okay, thank you.